Hey friends, Amy McMillan here, mobile vestibular therapist in Northeast Ohio. I wanted to do a video today on the topic, should you sleep upright with BPPV, either to prevent it or treat it? And the reason that this came up was because I've had a couple patients in the past 15 years who I would suggest, honestly, not to consistently sleep elevated. But you know, everybody's journey is different. And you'll see different practitioners out there saying, don't advise your patients to change their sleeping position. There's no evidence to support that. And I do see conflicting evidence. It's not very exactly clear cut. There's always gray area when it comes to science. So I wanted to share my two cents, and I also wanted to share with you an article, a research article that I did find. I will tell you that I only have three patients in the past 15 years who do sleep upright about 45 degrees, and the reason is because their BPPV is intractable. It can't be treated. They cannot tolerate treatment and maneuvers, or every time they lay flat, they do get it again. And just because those people are not in a research study doesn't mean sleeping upright doesn't work for them. So unfortunately, there's gray area. I wanted to share my viewpoint and a research article to support those findings. So everybody's journey is different. Let's take a look at this research article and you can make a decision for yourself. So I am going to share my screen. Alrighty. So this article was actually from 2019. So it's relatively recent. So head up sleeping may cure patients with intractable BPPV. It was a 6-month trial. So what intractable was with these particular patients, the canal repositioning maneuvers that we typically will use to treat BPPV would be your Foster maneuver, Epley, Semont, if you have it in the horizontal canal, Gofoni, force prolonged positioning, or barbecue roll. Those are just off the top of my head. So these particular patients could not be treated successfully, yet they still had positional vertigo. The study started out with 611 patients. 201 were intractable. They also limited that number to 88, which were idiopathic. I believe I read that they ruled out BPPV. They ruled some of the patients or participants out if they had head trauma or neck issues, anything that may have convoluted the process. So 88 of those patients were enrolled in the study. They were randomly assigned to either a heads up sleeping, which was a 45 degree angle or higher, or a head down sleeping under 45 degrees. So maybe one pillow or flat. So let's see, before treatment, they definitely ruled in the BPPV and the different variants here. It does say that their backgrounds did not significantly differ, meaning basically, the patients were background the same, whether it was gender or age, didn't significantly differ between who they were. Visual analog scale of dizziness. So if you've seen those scales, it goes from 0 to 10. How dizzy are you? 0 means none, 10, horribly dizzy. You'll see that the heads up sleeping group at the 3rd and 6th month had lower visual analog scores. So subjectively, the patients were reporting that they felt better in the heads up sleeping group. Again, it was also in 3 and 6 months. Furthermore, in the heads up sleeping group, the subjective visual vertigo was significantly lower. Now that test is a test of, I guess what I would call skew, meaning if this is upright and I think that this is me standing upright, subjective visual vertigo means that a patient might feel like they're actually tipped and that this is normal. So subjective visual vertigo is something that was also looked at, and patients felt more upright in the heads-up sleeping group. So the argument here was that if you have aging inner ears, otoliths, and those crystals aren't adhering onto that jelly pad in the vestibular system that they're supposed to, that when you lay down at night, they can just flow into those canals and cause your vertigo when you're upright. And it's not exactly a good idea for patients to consistently have the crystals go back into the canal and cause their dizziness. It's very anxiety provoking and it doesn't feel good. So what they're finding and they suggested was the heads up sleeping group, when lying down at home, you could recommend initial treatment for 3 to 6 months, according to this study, to treat intractable BPPV if nothing else works. And I don't know about you, but I would take it if I felt dizzy every day, which is why I wanted to do this. Let me see if I can stop sharing. So this is why I wanted to do this video. Again, as I said it before, everybody's journey is different. To have somebody go through a vertigo attack every morning when you sit up, is not a great way to start your day. So I just wanted to let you know that if you feel better with heads up sleeping, there is an article to support your decision. It is your decision. It is your body. I want you to feel safe and comfortable and have function throughout your day. The caveat or the negative to that is we want to make sure that you don't have fear avoidance with things like looking up temporarily or leaning back some. We also don't want your neck to be sore or for you to get headaches. So there are some cons to heads up sleeping and modifying your behavior. I don't want you to be hypervigilant and avoid anything that would make you uncomfortable, but I get it. You need sleep and you need to function. So if you have intractable BPPV, the maneuvers aren't working, there's an option out there for you. If you have any questions at all, leave them in the comments below and I'll be happy to answer them as they come up. Also, I'm always open to taking different topics that you want me to cover as well. So, drop those in the comments if you have any ideas or any issues that you'd like me to cover. So, until I see you next week, stay healthy, stay steady, and stay strong.